From the invasion of giant murder hornets to COVID-19 and dinosaur discoveries, here are 12 mind-blowing events reported in 2020. Japanese giant hornet. Twice the size of normal hornets, the Japanese giant hornet is so big that it is known as the giant sparrow bee, and it's about the size of a small bird. It has officially been spotted in the US of A, and we thought we were safe. Nope. One of the deadliest insects on the planet, these hornets live in cooperative hives and are highly effective predators. The Japanese hornet has 5 eyes, with 3 smaller eyes on the top of its head and 2 large compound eyes on either side. The better to see you with, my dear. Just so you know how to recognize it, it's yellow and brown, looks mean, and its enormous size will give it away. An extremely aggressive insect, they are highly territorial, and the sting is said to feel like a red-hot nail being hammered into you. YouTuber Nathaniel Coyote Peterson got stung by a Japanese hornet on purpose. He was writhing around and yelling for quite some time, so that should shed some light on how painful it is. 20 to 40 people are killed by giant hornets every year, mostly from anaphylactic shock. Even healthy individuals who aren't allergic to the hornet's sting can fall victim to their deadly venom, a toxin that can eat human tissue and destroy red blood cells. Plus, they don't usually sting just once. They will sting repeatedly, injecting more and more venom. The giant hornets are attracted to human sweat, alcohol, and sweet flavors and smells. They are especially sensitive when animals or people run, and they will start to swarm and attack. Some victims have required hundreds of stitches and numerous dialysis treatments to survive, and are still left with deep scars. It's actually better to let one or two sting you and keep a brave face than to run, because it will just be worse. Fun fact, there is now Japanese vodka made from the fermented giant hornet venom, and a sports drink made from hornet spit. These guys are actually highly dangerous invasive predators because they go after honeybees. 3 of them can destroy a whole hive in just about 30 minutes. That's 30 to 40,000 bees gone, and they are already in trouble. 2020 just can't get any worse. Or can it? First extinction of the year. It didn't take long for an animal to be listed as extinct in 2020. By the end of January, the Chinese paddlefish was unofficially declared as such. They were an ancient fish species with a lineage that stretched back some 200 million years. Paddlefish inhabited the Yangtze River, where they were recognized as one of the world's largest freshwater fish. The silvery animals could measure some 23 feet, 7 meters, and weigh up to 1,100 pounds, 500 kilograms. Even larger sizes were reported. Researchers say that the fish probably disappeared for good at some point between 2005 and 2010. Even though they survived mass extinction events that killed off dinosaurs and plesiosaurs, the paddlefish couldn't survive the actions of humans. A combination of factors including overfishing and habitat destruction decimated their population to the extent they had insufficient numbers to meaningfully reproduce. Most researchers think the species was functionally extinct as early as 1993. The Tully Monster Enigma. Since it was discovered over 60 years ago, this creature has always baffled researchers. It existed more than 300 million years ago, and its remains have only been found in the Mazan Creek fossil beds of Illinois. It was first discovered by a man named Francis Tully, hence the nickname. It has a super bizarre appearance, which is why it was called a monster. Although, for a monster, it wasn't very big. They were soft-bodied creatures that measured up to 14 inches long, 35 centimeters, along with several strange characteristics. It had jaws located inside a long proboscis. That suggested it might have eaten food that was hidden deep within the nooks and crannies of rivers and streams. But it has never been easy to officially classify them. Their fossils have been variously interpreted as worms, mollusks, or arthropods. Paleontologist Victoria McCoy of Britain's University of Leicester, who conducted the study while at Yale University, said, "I would rank the Tully monster just about at the top of the scale of weirdness." Recent research published in 2020 has most likely solved the mystery of what the Tully monster was. Finally, a team of researchers affiliated with several institutions in the US and one in Germany has found evidence that suggests the Tully monster was a vertebrate. Due to the presence of a rudimentary spinal cord that may have supported its body and gills, some researchers were convinced it was a predatory vertebrate species. Facial recognition. When it comes to recognizing their fellow creatures by the face, vertebrates are typically the acknowledged masters. Humans take this ability for granted, although crows, goats, and octopi are pretty good at it too. National Geographic reports that now we can add another member to this club. Researchers have found that the northern paper wasp is able to recognize the faces of other wasps with sharp accuracy. Researchers have found that this species can pick out individual faces from a crowd. Findings published in 2020 say they're one of the few insects with this ability. This demonstrates their strong, multi-colony social structure. They have multiple queens, and they all want to reproduce. By being able to recognize each other, this study says that it helps them understand who has beaten who and who has a higher ranking to keep the peace. What's really amazing is how quickly the trait evolved. Apparently, instead of a slow and steady process, their facial recognition talent appeared in a single evolutionary leap. Ancient elephants, great and small. Today, the African bush elephant is acknowledged as the world's largest terrestrial land mammal. But 800,000 years ago, elephants the size of small donkeys were once found on Mediterranean islands. The relatives of these dwarf elephants lived through Europe and Asia and grew to prodigious sizes. They're all placed within the genus of Palaeoloxodon, or straight-tusked elephants. But for a long time, it was unknown if the European and Indian animals belonged to the same species or were distinct. Researchers found a clue in the size of the animal's skull crests. Some of the fossils exhibited pronounced crests, while others were much smaller. Now, it turns out that the creatures with larger crests are indeed distinct from those with smaller crests. So, there were once two separate species of enormous elephants. The European species had a slender crest, while the Indian species was more robust. The latter beast may have been the largest terrestrial animal ever. Hard to believe that these and the dwarf elephants were related. If you want to learn more, the full findings of the study were published in the journal Quaternary Science Reviews. Cicadas emerge from the ground. Apparently, 2020 is the year that cicadas will emerge from the ground after 17 years, as if we didn't have enough going on. While cicadas aren't locusts, it still seems like a biblical event. Scientists say that farmers with grapevines and fruit trees especially should be extra prepared for the invasion since they can pose a danger to crops. In the southern US, there will be 1.5 million of the insects emerging per acre. And they make a lot of noise. Every 17 years, cicadas emerge from the ground to crawl towards the sky, with the majority peaking in early June. Most will be gone by July. Communities and farms with large numbers of cicadas emerging at once may have a substantial noise issue. Eric Day, an entomologist in Virginia Tech's College of Agriculture and Life Sciences, said in a statement. That noise, the college says, is the mating call of the males who are attempting to attract females. The bugs implant their eggs into branches or vines, causing them to split and wither. If too many cicadas lay eggs in a small tree, it can kill the plant. We still don't know much about these creatures, like why they come out every 13 to 17 years. But if you are unaffected, like Doug Pfeiffer, a professor at Virginia Tech's Department of Entomology, says, you should enjoy marveling at the fascinating and puzzling bugs. Mythical beings, real history. Rock carvings dating back some 3,000 years were recently unveiled by archaeologists in northern Iraq. The ancient carvings depict an Assyrian king, several deities, and a procession of mythical animals. Several characters are portrayed in the panels, including the main Assyrian gods Asher and Ishtar. They are mounted atop a dragon and a horned lion, respectively. Five other gods and goddesses are also shown seated or standing on mythical beasts. 10 panels of carvings have so far been recovered above the remains of a canal that was built in the 8th century BC. These carvings were buried for several years on purpose to prevent damage from militant military groups. It wasn't until this past year that archaeologists could go and uncover these beautiful ancient carvings again. Experts say it's the first time in nearly 2 centuries that comparable Assyrian rock carvings have been revealed. Located about 300 miles north, 480 kilometers of Baghdad, archaeologists say that with the exception of carvings at Kinnis, another archaeologist site, there is no other Assyrian rock complex that can compare to Feda. Largest ever Australian carnivore. A team of researchers identified fossils found in central West Queensland as the largest theropod that ever inhabited Australia. A farmer in the town of Winton initially discovered several fragmented fossils of limbs and vertebrae in 2017. However, the study was not published until 2020. Those fossils resembled the remains of another dino found near Winton, called an Australovenator. It was a two-legged carnivorous beast that lived some 95 million years ago. The recently discovered fossils belonged to a larger theropod that stood more than 6.5 feet tall, 2 meters, measured some 23 feet, 7 meters long, and probably weighed over 2,200 pounds. The size and shape of their clawed hands indicate that they were predators that probably fed on quadruped herbivores. Researchers still are not sure whether it might have had feathers. It's the biggest known carnivore that ever lived in Oz, and only the third theropod ever found there. Caller unknown. Fast radio bursts, or FRBs, were first detected in 2007 from data analyzed at the Parkes Observatory in Australia. These radio pulses are transient and generally last for a few milliseconds at most. While astronomers have identified the phenomenon, its origin is still a mystery, but maybe that will soon change. Researchers in Canada have located an isolated radio burst that occurs 500 million light years away. Over a 16-day cycle, it periodically sends out a signal once every hour for a few milliseconds at a time. It repeats this process every hour for 4 days. The signal then goes silent for 12 days, after which it resumes the 16-day cycle. It's the first time a regular pattern has been displayed by an FRB. Although it's easy to suspect an extraterrestrial intelligence is causing it, researchers say it's unlikely. Sending messages over a 16-day cycle would be inefficient, to say the least. Like all FRBs, this deep space event is still a mystery. Who or what do you think is calling? Tell us what you think in the comments. Radioactive dinosaur. Allosaurus was a carnivorous bipedal dinosaur that existed around 155 million years ago. Its name means different lizard, and that certainly applies to a new species that was officially described in 2020. This particular dino specimen was radioactive. Actually, that's not entirely accurate. To get the full picture, we have to go back to 1990 when the dinosaur's headless skeleton was found encased in rock in Utah. In 1996, the animal's skull was finally located. Researchers used a radiation detector to discover it near the location of the skeleton. So, the skull was radioactive. But paleontologists say it's not unusual for radioactive elements to seep into dino bones from the surrounding sediment. After the skull was reunited with the skeleton, it was identified as a new dinosaur species. It's now regarded as the oldest Allosaurus to inhabit western areas of North America. This carnivore would have stood nearly 30 feet tall, 9 meters, and weighed around 4,000 pounds, 1.8 metric tons. With dozens of sharp, serrated teeth filling its skull, this beast would have been at the top of the food chain. The novel coronavirus, aka COVID-19. This is one recent event that is mind-blowing for all the wrong reasons. I'm sure you've heard more than you wanted to already, but it is one of the defining things of 2020. Coronaviruses cause diseases in mammals and birds. When it infects humans, it can trigger respiratory infections like the common cold. These effects are typically mild, but sometimes they can turn lethal. And that's what happened with the novel coronavirus that originated in Wuhan, China in late 2019. A pneumonia outbreak was linked to a novel strain of coronavirus that resembles SARS. Severe acute respiratory syndrome, which is transmitted from animals to humans. Some researchers think it originated in snakes, but many now think it was transferred from bats. The coronavirus outbreak carried into 2020 and was declared a global health crisis by the World Health Organization. The virus has been spread by human-to-human contact from Asia to more than 24 countries from Europe to North America and Oceania. The United States has so far experienced the greatest number of virus-related deaths. As the pandemic continues, scientists are working non-stop in search of a vaccine. In the meantime, try to stay home as much as possible and wear a mask. Raptors rebound. We don't want to end on a depressing note, so here's something more positive. The Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources stated in 2020 that the state's bald eagle population has made a dramatic comeback since 1974. Nearly 1,700 occupied bald eagle nests were recorded during an aerial survey. Experts say the success story is largely tied to a nationwide ban on the pesticide DDT, which helped cause a severe drop in the bird's population. The raptors have made a remarkable comeback in the 48 contiguous United States. In the 1990s, they were listed as critically endangered or threatened. Now it seems in 2020, they are happy and healthy. Thanks for watching. Remember, knowledge is power. Remember to hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.